Hello, my dear friends, and welcome to StudyIQ. I'm Joy C. Joy, and today, in this lecture, we will be discussing about the rising water demand of the energy sector in India. Here, we will see what is the issue regarding the increasing water demand in the energy sector and how it is going to impact the overall water consumption. We will also see what is the situation of water crisis in India, and we will understand the dependency of power sector or the energy sector on water resources. We will also see what are the solutions for this, and also we will analyze what is the role of CWMI, that is Composite Water Management Index, in this regard. So let us start. First of all, let us analyze what is the current affair, why this issue has become an important news. So the water demand for the energy sector is increasing, and it is estimated that in the coming years it will again increase. And this rising demand in the energy sector for water resources makes it necessary that the water consumption in the sector needs to be reported. That means there should be more transparency as well as accountability of the water usage in the energy sector. So we will analyze this issue in detail. Now let us understand what is the situation of water crisis in India. CWMI stands for Composite Water Management Index, and it is maintained by the Niti Aayog. And according to the Composite Water Management Index maintained by the Niti Aayog, around 600 million people face high to extreme water stress in India. So the number is very huge. They face extreme water stress. Now if we analyze the Water Quality Index report, it places India at 120 out of a total of 122 countries. So the position of India is very bad according to the Water Quality Index report. And according to the Water Quality Index report, there is a chance that India can lose up to 6% of GDP by the year 2030 because of this extreme water crisis. So the prediction is that this persistent water crisis will lead to an eventual 6% GDP loss for the country. So this has an economic impact as well. And what is the reason for that? Extreme water scarcity will lead to lowering of productivity. It can be the productivity of physical resources or human resources. For example, let us take human resources. If there is extreme water scarcity, it will affect the health and hygiene of an individual. So it will deteriorate the standard of living. So when the standard of living comes down, what will happen? The productivity of that person will come down. So this will lead to lowering productivity. That means the production capacity or the labor capacity will come down. That means there will be a negative impact on the GDP. Again, secondly, physical resources. It can be either natural resources or man-made resources. For example, machines. So machines require water. Most of the sectors are dependent on water for many purposes. Industries are dependent on water. So what happens? When there is a water scarcity, there will be lack of availability of this water resource, and this will lead to decrease in the productivity. So when productivity decreases, what happens? The overall output will come down, and GDP measures the output in an economy. So when output comes down, the GDP also will come down, and when there is a decrease in GDP, it means the growth of the economy is impacted. So we can say that scarcity of water even has a economic impact in the form of lowering the growth rate of the economy by bringing down the GDP. So here the Water Quality Index report has predicted that India can have a 6% of GDP loss. That means an output loss by the year 2030 if this water crisis continues. And the same Water Quality Index report has predicted that there will be a vast gulf between the demand and the supply. That means the demand for water resources will be much higher than the supply of the water resources. This supply has come down because there is a scarcity. The resources that are available to meet this demand is limited, but this demand is unlimited. So this unlimited demand and limited resources makes a vast gulf or gap between the demand and supply. This is applicable especially in case of freshwater resources. Now let us understand the dependency of power sector in the water resources, or what is the water dependency of the power sector. In the year 2015, the CWC, that is the Central Water Commission, has predicted that or reported that the sector-wise requirement of water will increase steeply between 2030 and 2050. So, there will be an increase in the demand sector-wise. That means every sector will have increased demand for water resources. And this requirement will be for both drinking and domestic use as well as for industry and energy. So, both for domestic purposes and for commercial purposes, the demand is estimated to be very high and would persistently increase between 2030 and 2050, and it will reach the highest by 2050. Now, we are discussing about the energy sector or the power sector and its dependency on water resources. Now, if we take the power sector alone, we will see that the water consumption or the share was 0.62% in the year 2010. So, from the 0.62% in 2010, it has increased to nearly 1%, and it is estimated that by 2030, this consumption or share of consumption will increase to 1.37%. This is by 2030, and it is estimated that by the year 2050, this will increase to 8.98%. Now, this is what the CWC or the Central Water Commission has also reported. That is, between 2030 and 2050 will be the highest increase. That means, it is estimated that in the energy sector alone, from 1.37% in 2030, it will increase to 8.98% in 2050. With regard to the share of water consumption. Now, within the power sector, if we analyze the thermal electricity, we will see that thermal electricity accounts for more than 86% of India's total power generation. So, 86% of India's power comes from the thermal energy. So, in case of thermal electricity, analysis shows that 77% of these thermal power plants are dependent on freshwater resources. And among the 77%, 40% of them are installed in areas with high or extremely high water stress. And along with this, it is estimated that by the year 2030, more than 70% of the India's existing thermal power plants will experience an increased level of competition, that is water competition, from agricultural, urban and other industrial areas or sectors. That means the water resources that are used by the thermal power plants in India at present, they will have to share it with other sectors like agriculture, urban and industries. So, there will be more demand for water resources. So, along with the present use and estimated future use, it is predicted that there will be serious water crisis in the country, especially with regard to the availability of freshwater resources. At present, the power sector consumes more water, but it is estimated that there will be increased competition from other sectors. So, this competition between the power sector and the other sectors like agriculture, urban development, industries, etc. will lead to further deterioration of the situation. Now, let us understand what is the way ahead for this solution. So, the CWMI, that is a composite water management index. So, CWMI raises three main issues related to this. So, what are the main issues? One is limited coverage, second one is unreliable data, and the third problem is the coordination and sharing between different departments. So, these three issues need to be addressed. So, in order to rectify these issues, the CWMI recommends that the daily water withdrawal and consumption data should be reported. And this should be made mandatory. So, this will give a transparent picture of the water resource consumption. This will help in proper checks and balances, whether the sector is complying with the norms and guidelines. So, this can be measured with the existing technology and added into this reporting framework. And such type of reporting will also help in the implementation of the MOEFCC notification. So, what is this MOEFCC notification? The ministry notification mandates a specific water consumption norms for the existing and new thermal plants. So, there is a limit or cap set for the existing thermal power plants as well as for new thermal power plants. Now, what is the issue? Because there is no proper reporting of the water consumption levels, it is difficult for the ministry to check whether they are complying with the norms. So once the reporting is made mandatory, proper assessment can be done whether these thermal power plants are complying with the guidelines of the ministry. So this will bring in better checks and balances. Now let us also understand what is the role of CWMI, Composite Water Management Index. So CWMI is expected to establish a public national platform that provides information on key water indicators. So this platform will provide a better information about the water indicators across the states. So this platform will be helpful in monitoring the performance of the indicators, also in improving the transparency and also encouraging competition among the states. Competition among the states in the sense that which state has fared well. So this in turn will help in fostering the spirit of competitive and cooperative federalism among the states. And this data which is provided in the platform can be used by the researchers, entrepreneurs, policy makers, etc. in order to create an enabling environment. So it will also provide information or research data that can be used by different stakeholders in order to come up with policies or guidelines. Now coming to the index. According to CWMI, that is Composite Water Management Index, the index noted that water scarce states in the country like Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Telangana, etc. They are the leaders in this index. And the report also noted that these states have become the leaders in this index because they are water scarce states. And because there is a scarcity of water in the states, they have made a judicious use of their water resources. You can find the PDF of this lecture on my Facebook page. And for any queries related to your UPSC preparations, you can get in touch with me on my Facebook page or you can email me at joycy.studyiq@gmail.com. Thank you.